What happens when a predator is introduced into an ecosystem? In 1995, we found out when 14 wolves were reintroduced into Yellowstone National Park. This wasn't a random decision. It was a calculated move by US and Canadian wildlife officials, a bold attempt to restore balance to an ecosystem that was teetering on the brink. But the reintroduction of these majestic predators was met with apprehension and even fear. After all, wolves had been absent from Yellowstone for nearly 70 years. Would they adapt? Would they survive? And what would their impact be on the park's existing wildlife? The answers to these questions were as unknown as the wilderness itself. But as the wolves began to settle in, their presence started to ripple through the park in ways no one could have predicted. Little did we know, these wolves were about to trigger a chain of events that would transform the park's ecosystem. The first change was immediately apparent: the deer population began to decline. With the introduction of the wolves, nature's most skilled hunters, the deer found themselves under pressure. The wolves hunted the deer with such efficiency that their numbers rapidly decreased. But this was not the only change. The deer naturally began to avoid certain areas of the park where they knew their new predators roamed. This led to a surprising effect. The areas the deer had once grazed were now left untouched, and something extraordinary happened. The forests of aspen and willow trees, once gnawed down by deer, began to flourish again. Their growth was unchecked, their branches reaching for the sky in places where they hadn't in years. And with the trees came the bushes, the berries, and a myriad of insects. The ecosystem started to shift, and new residents began to make their homes amidst the flourishing vegetation. Songbirds returned, their music filling the air, and the insect population provided a feast for them. As more trees grew, another unexpected guest arrived: the beavers. They, in turn, built dams, their industrious nature creating habitats for otters, muskrats, and a host of reptiles. But the chain of events didn't stop there. The wolves also made a significant impact on the coyote population. As the coyotes fell, the populations of rabbits and mice began to surge. This, in turn, created more food for a range of predators, including hawks, red foxes, and badgers. The balance between predators and prey shifted again, creating a thriving ecosystem where species began to flourish. And the landscape? It transformed too. With increased vegetation, erosion decreased, the rivers began to run clearer, their banks stabilized by the roots of growing plants. The park was changing, evolving, becoming something new and vibrant. The effect of the wolves was far-reaching, influencing not just the animal species but the very landscape of the park itself.